somebody came in, decided to be racist, calling him all kinds of niggers, fucking niggers. It was a 77-year-old man. He punched him, he hit the ground, and he died 3 days later, if I'm correct.
Yep, that's correct.
A Blessing Ali Flavor Podcast. Hey, your boy, Young Ty.
And your boy, Big Tice.
And it's the only podcast running down viral news and interviews. Let's get into this. What's in other news?
All right, baby. So let's get into this and start with the Florida Dunkin employee sentenced to house arrest for fatally punching customer over racial slur.
Oh my God.
Reaction to a racial slur has turned deadly, and now a Tampa Dunkin Donuts employee is facing charges. Police say the fast food worker punched a 77-year-old man after he directed a number of those slurs at the employee. 3 days later, the elderly man has died.
All right. So, if you will remember the video, this is an update. So we had this young man, he was working at Dunkin Donuts. Somebody came in, decided to be racist, calling him all kinds of niggers, fucking niggers. It was a 77-year-old man. He punched him, he hit the ground, and he died 3 days later. If I'm correct.
Yep, that's correct. A brief recall is Corey Puyols, who is the one who was actually sentenced to house arrest, went in to just calm the altercation originally, but he was called the N-word. And then he said, please leave. And the N-word was once again repeated, and things went to another level.
He got dropped like a bag of rice, if you can dig me.
Precisely.
Yes. Big Tice.
Talk to me.
I've done the math. So the victim is 77 years old. I did the math. He was born between 1944 and 1945, which means that he participated in a lot of bullshit back in the day, because segregation didn't end until approximately 1962, 63, and it's still going on arguably to today. So you can't tell me, Young Tice, Big Tice, that he wasn't involved in some bullshit back in the day. Can you dig me?
Well, I gotta say, my boy lived a high-risk lifestyle, and I guess the chickens just done came to roost.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody deserves to die, you know what I mean? But some people, you know what I mean, they ask for it. What's in the news?
Okay, next we have an interesting TikTok story for y'all.
Oh.
Psychologists concerned about TikTok becoming dangerous, breeding ground for mental illness and different mental disorders.
Duh. Have you ever been on TikTok, my bro?
You know, I try to stay away from it, but yeah, enlighten me.
It's a madness. So anyway, if you ever been on TikTok before, which I know you have, some people think that Instagram's crazy, right? Instagram can hurl a candle to TikTok. TikTok, you got every and anything on TikTok, you hear me? You got people, I'm not even gonna go into it. TikTok is a mental illness playground. Woo! Not to make light of mental illness at all, but people on TikTok, they embrace mental illness. They try to make other people, you know, get on that wave of mental illness. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. They celebrate mental illness. Why would you celebrate mental illness? You're going to celebrate having a broken arm? You're going to celebrate having a curl? No, that deal. Come on, nah. TikTok is a crazy, crazy place.
Yeah, I recognize that. They actually spoke in this article about how psychologists recognize how there's a lot of people pretending to have different types of syndromes.
Fast.
And they're saying that, for example, I have Tourette's, so they're like, oh, you know,
and they're putting it on.
They're doing it just for
bro,
entertainment. And it's like, you know, this is a serious situation.
It is.
And then it goes to another level, where there's other people out there called hypochondriacs. That's your word of the day.
Hypochondriac.
And these are people who overreact about certain types of mental health or any type of illness.
Health disorder. For sure.
They could assume that they have it. And therefore, these types of things influence people to behave in a crazy manner.
All I'm knowing is that the world's been a worse place since TikTok came around. Yeah, feel me? Because TikTok teaches people, like, anybody could get on there, like, doing the craziest things, and then you see like 500,000 views, a million views. It's somebody hitting us over the head with something, and it's got a million views, and other people, they see that, it's a compound effect. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, it is.
They see that and they're like, oh, let me do some crazy shit, and it just stacks up, and then everybody going crazy. You feel
me? And that's a fact. And everybody's out here wondering, you know, it seems like everything's a bit different. Why is everybody on edge right now? Why is everybody? Nobody's on edge. What you mean? What you mean on edge?
It's TikTok, baby.
Ain't nobody on edge.
Nobody's on edge right now.
Is that social media is penetrating that body, baby?
Indeed. You gotta watch what you're putting into your mind, baby. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And on that note, what's in other news?
All right, final, a little good news for you. Just a little
please,
baby.
I beg you.
We got Top Boy coming back on the Netflix, fam.
Cheese.
This Friday, tune in on the Netflix to get that Top Boy thing, man.
What are you talking about, babe?
I'm talking about that Top Boy,
on
man.
Friday.
It's nothing but a Top Boy thing, fam.
Are you serious, babe?
You already know that.
Yeah, man. New things. Bigger things are coming right now from Top Boy. We're looking forward still.
Yeah, big up Summerhouse, innit?
Yo, big up Hackney.
Hey!
Big up everybody in the East.
Hey!
Big up everybody in the South.
Hey!
Big up everybody in Pecknall, where we used to live still. Pecknall, right? We've been whole close.
Jeez!
Top Boy is back, boy. We're excited. And on that note, like, subscribe. Blessing Ali Flavor Podcast. BHFTV on Instagram, to be exact. Your boy, Young Ty.
Big Tights signing out, and sign back in next week for some mo.
Get under the umbrella or get wet.